Ian Graham Cox, 13 David Mark Thomas, 15 Andrew Goman dan Carson Rusha. Graham Cox berhadapan dengan Zagorodnev dan halang di sana oleh Arya Patian. Masih lagi DJ Williams. Ya, satu gerak yang
Andrew Weston akan menampan. Andrew menampan, Robert memukul. Itu dia bola masuk. Walaupun dan Robert memukul penjaga gol Jepun, walaupun begitu bola masuk Andrew Weston masuk Andrew Weston dalam menit ke
akan merembat Robert Cottrell timbun di mengwis
Kualista Maria dribble tak ulang diri dan di pintas.
Now that's ball, it's Hefakos to Brough to Peters, and that's a goal to Wales. Wales open the scoring with a great goal 18 minutes into the game from David Peters, the Welsh fullback number one. Wales 1, Holland 0. What a... on the edge of the circle. Oh, here's a chance, Tom Vanatek, and the ball, well, that was a good save by Chris Ashcroft, hitting Chris Ashcroft's body just as he went down to the save from Tom Vanatek.
Kans voor Nederland om 4-1 te maken. Nou, dat gaat natuurlijk vanzelfsprekend. Lag hij erin, lag hij er niet in, het is niet belangrijk. En uiteindelijk heeft hij gelijk gekregen. En misschien is dat wel de kennis, een stukje geluk van de goede coach. In ieder geval mag Nederland na deze 4-1 overwinning...
The players' expressions on...
What's the secret?
Ian Taylor.
Easy to manage, sometimes.
What's it done for the game of hockey, this?
Well, it's a terrific thing for our game, you know.
Soviets, the current European silver medalists from the last tournament, playing here in the Dynamo Minor Stadium in Moscow.
Bachelor of Southgate, and Shawani Astarport makes it 3. And the players are off the bench this time.
Champion, Great Britain.
Of our team, compounded, I think, because perhaps in other sports.
Shocky, though, is the trend for the best players who want to improve their game to leave and play for top English clubs. The intensive league structure in England provides first-class competition week in, week out, and gives that extra edge to Welsh players with international ambitions.
It can't obviously help, because if you're taking the best players out, then there's very, very few chances for the younger players coming through to actually learn from the better players who are actually playing international hockey.
Not me.
Too bad, Hacks.
The Welsh players in great heart, despite the fact it was pretty parky in Paris too.
Manitoba.
there's confirmation of the game coming up. The Span cap's going into the tournament for him. Watch out for him.
Richard Jones, he may well be a dummy striker. We'll see. Oh, that's a great goal. That's a great goal. There's a stop. Slipped for Hacker high into the Spanish net, and they'll be delighted with that, David. Oh. Now, Ian Hughes-Rowland with a chance to make a name for himself. Well, he's got two already, and he's another one. But a good run there from Hughes Rowlands. Can they pull one back? Again, a very complicated routine, but it's gone in. Scored, I think, in the end by David Hacker.
Maybe. And Dave Hacker this time does put Wales ahead. Three-two at the end. What about the Welsh performance?
In terms of our final group position, or rather final position in the tournament, today's result wasn't necessarily important.
And no easy sides at all. It's very, very tough.
The other sides involved make up an impressive who's who of the game.
It's a very big event. Any tournament that involves Pakistan, Malaysia and GB, the current Olympic gold medalists, it is a big tournament, and obviously we in Wales are very pleased to be part of it.
The boys played very well, really. Yeah, there's a lot of character shown today. Again, I think you've already, you know, seen the strength of the Indian side.
To a Dublin bathed in Mediterranean sunshine, a Gaelic adventure for this championship full of highs and lows. It wasn't just the statues that felt the heat.
O'Sullivan, that's a very good ball to Markham. Two players in the circle. Oh, the touch just eluded. This is Iscara again in the circle, and another wonderful save by Ashcroft. As he comes into the circle, he takes on Ashcroft, beats him, flicks it, and Coakley gets the touch one-handed to the back line, and he put the ball backwards. And there was a chance for Spain. but a brilliant tackle by Edwards. Good ball. Stephen Vain shoots. Well saved by Priday. Oh. That's a good hit. Oh, and a touch. Oh, Grimes got a touch.
Hello for Great Britain in Seoul as they send the ball across, and surely a chance to open the account, and he does. Johnson threads a good one through. They should score here. Brilliant save. They still have a chance for the Ireland. Time the penalty. Yes, Reese again. Reese will pump it in now. Reese does. Good defensive work from Leeper. And a chance for the shot. A good save off the pads. Number two. And it's in. Coakley.
By the wedge number five, Clive O'Sullivan. To Coakley. Good break here. And it's Abdu. Abdu taking on the fair. And Abdu's ready. He's taken down. Penalty stroke. Penalty stroke to Wales. Whistle. And it's in. By Paul Edwards, his second goal for Waits, blows the whistle, and it's a great save by Lefebvre. He keeps his team in it, touches it.
Reece tries to get into the circle, wins the free just outside the circle. So a chance for Wales, gets it across. It's a great shot. That's a terrific shot by Reece.
Finals themselves will take place in 1998 in Utrecht.
The city of Kuala Lumpur was awarded the celebration of these games 6 years ago. 39 gold, 47 silver, 66 bronze. A good return.
Thank you.
10 for the City.
A sound start for the men's hockey team and a 1-1 draw with Canada. Simon Organ gave Wales the lead with a penalty stroke midway through the second half. His 60th goal in his 61st international. Wayne Fernandez equalised for Canada from a penalty corner. And Wales now face the mighty Pakistan tomorrow. And more woe from the men's hockey competition. Wales's 3-0 defeat to the mighty Pakistan leaves them bottom of their group. Played two, drawn one, lost one.
Today was do or die for the Welsh hockey team at Bellevue, but they were completely swept off a rain-soaked pitch by England, eventually losing 5-0. Wales finished bottom of Pool B with just one draw and one goal in three games. It hasn't been the best of tournaments for the men's hockey team, but they were determined to end on a winning note. And that's just what they did, avoiding the dreaded wooden spoon by beating the tournament's whipping boys Barbados. 7-0 was Wales' eventual margin of victory, and though they won't have any medals to take home, Simon Organ will have the lasting memory of a hat-trick in the Commonwealth Games. The Welsh hockey team finished 7th, Barbados 8th.
It's a game that we had to get a result in, draw or a win. A positive performance is the main thing.
Matt, 30 seconds, first game of the tournament, a goal to Scotland. How did you feel as captain?
Pretty nervous. It couldn't have started any worse, really. But the good thing about it was it just gave us time to get back into the game. And I always felt we were good enough to win the game. And the reaction was absolutely fantastic for the lads. A bit nervy for the first sort of 6-7 minutes, and then I thought we bossed the rest of the first half.
And obviously Rhys Joyce's goal to bring it in at 1-0 at half-time was a crucial win for the Wales team.
Crucial and slightly unexpected. From a man who scored twice in, I think, 90 games, to score two in one game was pretty unheard of. But, it was a great goal, great team press, and just finished off really well.
It was pretty pleasing. Don't score many goals, but I was happy to get on the score sheet, and just important for us to get back in the game.
I think we've played Scotland loads of times over the last couple of years, and they know we've got a corner threat, just like we know they have. It would have been a big part of their game trying to stop us getting corners, and to score two from two was absolutely fantastic, especially seeing as they were only 2 minutes apart. It was a great time in the game.
Goals for you and Rick this tournament so far. Who's going to be the lead scorer by the end of the tournament?
The smart money's on Rick. I'm a very outside horse, I'd say.
Okay.
We feel as a group that the world rankings don't do Wales justice, and the most important thing for us is to sort it out this week. So the more results we get, the better it's going to be for us.
You know, with the women doing well in Rome, they've qualified the World Cup and Commonwealth Games. Is that a little bit of pressure on the men to do the same?
I don't think it's pressure. I think it just shows that Welsh hockey is going forward, and I think all age groups have done really well this year, and I think we should, as a nation, should be really proud of what we've achieved.
For us, we're aiming for a semi-final slot. That's always been our aim, and we put ourselves in that position. It's a one-off game, and if we can win that, we're in the A division, and I think pretty much if we do that, we'll guarantee ourselves all the other things. So our aim is really to get into that final and give ourselves the best possible opportunity. If we do that, I think the other stuff will come from there, but we just concentrate on this next game, hopefully make sure we back up yesterday's performance today.
And in front of not only a Wales crowd but a Wrexham crowd, your home crowd, how does that feel for you?
Yeah, it's pretty massive for me. I've been looking forward to this tournament ever since it got firstly announced, massive for me, and lots of home support yesterday and big cheers and really, really excited, and it was ace. Yeah, really good.
I'm Ryan Jones.
And I'm Wales' number one hockey player, Nick Rees.
And welcome to the Commonwealth Games.
people. And it's been fantastic having you, flags from all around the world. And from me and the team, behind the scenes, wherever you are in the world, have a fantastic day. And we'll see you again in 4 years' time in Australia. Bye-bye.